Welcome aboard, sailors. I'm Captain Punkin, and I'm hungry for some Dark Souls 3 DLC, Ashes of Ariandel.
Alright, so this is what the painted world of Ariandel looks like from the bonfire warp system. Yeah, a snowfield, a rope bridge cave, Ariandel Chapel, depths of the painting, which is like that ice lake that we saw earlier, and then the champion's grave tender. So we need to go to the rope bridge cave? Yeah. Oh man, but having access to a place where you can just go in and fight everyone you encounter is such a boon. I'm hoping that it's going to increase the amount of high quality players that we start encountering. I mean, I got my ass handed to me 4 out of 4 times in those duels. So I'm quite sure that we're going to start seeing the really tough players out there. I mean, I'm almost unstoppable in PvE, but when it comes to PvP, I'm not so good because I usually use heavier weapons, and those are predictable, and when you become predictable in PvP, you start dying. It's a sad but true fact. Okay, but speaking of which, let's switch out for the Exile Greatsword, because that's kind of like Sakura's signature weapon at this point. And if she can... Is there anything here that she can also use? No? I don't think so. Yeah, it's okay. Follower armor. Huh. So, oh yeah. That's fun. That's just pure fun. I gotta remember what? Where is it? I hear something. Is it up? Is it down? Is it left? Is it under me? Maybe. Where are you? Where am I, for that matter? But I gotta tell you, being in a completely new area is scary. Oh, and we can actually see where the area down there. So it gives you a hint that there might be something new nearby. There's something over there. Let's see, how do we get up there? Not up there, but... onto that platform is what I'm talking about. Oh, do you get there from that bridge wall right there? Let's see. Yeah, these things screaming, it's a bit bone-chilling, I must admit. This is ideal quality for so close to Halloween. Oh, I know what these things are. They're gonna grow into the assassin-looking mofo that killed us last time. Aren't they? You guys are loud! Yeah, you dropped a poop! He dropped a poop for me! Oh. Okay. Ah! These zombie crow motherfuckers. Stop screaming in my ears, for Pete's sake! That hurts! And over here, we should find, yeah, the mannequin-looking douche. Oh, wait. I parried him? Bird is the word. Bird is the word. Okay, so you can also get large titanite shards from those guys. And remember, this is New Game Plus, so for me, these enemies are much harder. I just want you guys to remember that. Okay, I'm just gonna take a look. And it's interesting fact, those trees are made of ice. They're not just white, they're actually made of ice. Which is kinda cool. It's not just kinda cool, it's really cool, if you ask me. Which some of you will say, I actually didn't, but you kinda did. Nah, you didn't. I know. I'll stop. I see rafters. Things like to hide in rafters. Is there something hiding in the rafters? Maybe. Somewhere? No? Okay. Well, something's choking, I think. It's alive. That thing's alive. It looks like it's carrying a thing of poop. Hello?
Oh. Well. There is nothing forlorn about you.
You motherfuckers can talk!
You must be the other Ash, I suppose.
I am Ash.
Oh, finally, you have come. Oh, wondrous Ash, grant us our wish. Make the tales true, and burn this world away. My lady must see flame, and you have only to show her.
I'm
you
still...
You are Ash, are you not? Is it not fire that you seek?
You want me to light her on fire?
Surely you've seen the rot that afflicts our world. But that which fooled the good father and buried the flame. After we had all made up our minds, too. So, please, grant us one wish.
So we have to reveal
the tales true.
The fire.
And burn this world away.
Okay.
My lady must see.
Okay, yeah, he keeps saying that. I keep hearing goopy goopies. Gooper. Seriously, what the hell? Is that your entrails or something? Man, you need to see a doctor. Or a surgeon. Okay, we got another bonfire. What's this one called? The Corvian Settlement. Okay, so these guys are Corvians. I get it. So the Corvians on the Road of Sacrifices, they're not full Corvians. Or maybe they are, and they just changed when they left this place. Because Corvians are apparently, well, that thing. They're the inhabitants of the Painted World. What? Something's moving down there, and it looks like it has feathers, and I'm willing to bet that it's another one of the freaky things. And there's that bastard! Bastard goddess. So, is this thing hostile? No, I don't think it is. Well, I'm about to get spooked, aren't I? Oh! What the fuck? Dude, go see a doctor. Oh, ow! Okay, but there's an item in there. I know you don't want me to see your house, but... You know, I can do this without hurting him. It's an ember. A See, as far as I can tell, that guy's not actually attacking me. Okay, yeah, maybe he is attacking me. I try to take a passive route when I can. Like, unless I'm grinding and I'm getting greedy and something. Hey! Douchebag! Don't kill the little guys! Ow! Nice cape, though. Well, maybe. Hold on. No, that's not a thing. Maybe if I go in the house? What is that noise? Ah! You okay, dude? Yeah, you look cold. Ow! Okay. I've had enough people pushing me. Stop pushing me! Damn! Ah! Oh my. I thought there was a thing there! Ow! They're not trying! They're like lemmings! I'm so sorry! Okay, yeah, you're actively trying to kill me. But you're so pathetic that I don't want to. That was rude. That was just rude. Okay, I've had about enough of that. Is this destructible? No. It's not. Yeah, I just screamed like a little girl back there. I'm so sorry. Okay, now they're a threat. Okay, how pathetic you look. Another DPA poop when you kill him. Man, this is a weird place. It's just a weird place in general. It's a crystal thingy. I'm not gonna. Oh my god! Ow! Ow, my face! Turd! That's what I'm gonna start calling these guys, the turd birds. Yeah, they're actually dead. I didn't even know that they could do a crazy-ass plunging attack like that. Venerable old hand. This looks somewhat familiar. For some reason. Yeah. Oh god. I didn't mean to fall off. Wait. Wary of ambush. And that's all that's back here? It's just for an ambush, just to fuck you over. Oh man, like you don't actually have to be here. Damn it! Oh man. What's with the eggs? Seriously. Are those Corvian eggs or something? I see ya! Gotcha, bitch! Ever since that one area in Bloodborne, I always check the corners.
I've seen your kind. Time and time again.
Oh?
Every fleeing man must be caught. Every secret must be unearthed. Such is the conceit of the self-proclaimed seeker of truth. You lack the stomach.
What the fuck was that?
That you'll bring upon yourself.
What did he do? What is this shit? Ah, that's the Onyx Blade. That's the blade. That's the sword that one of my other characters wants. What?
Forgive me, my lady. Swore an oath. But I have failed, lady. Elfrida.
Okay. And now we have the Onyx Blade. Something that is actually really cool. Okay, let's take a look at the sword itself first. I mean, look at that. That is one sick design. Okay, and we can't actually shroud this thing because we don't have enough intelligence. Yeah, but I mean, just look at the thing. Hold on, let's see if I can get a closer look at the Quillians here. Quillians is another is the proper term for the guard of a sword. I mean, look at that. It does remind me of a different sword that you find in the game. I can't remember what it's called, though. It's got, like, prongs and shit, but yeah. That's gonna be really cool, and this thing is a great sword class. It's not an ultra. And look at that length! It looks like it's longer than the Moonlight Sword. Hold on, do I have one on me? No, I don't. Sorry. Let's take a look at its abilities. Ooh, I like. Uh, Okay, yeah. It's effectively the Moonlight Sword, but with a black fire version of it. And I am going to relish using this thing, because just look at its appearance. But that won't be until PvP much later. Okay, I think... No, I was using the Refined Exile. Okay. Something bad's about to happen. Okay. Is there something freaky up there? Probably is. This is Dark Souls, after all. Begin by casting Replenishment. So that my health bar will just regenerate by itself over time. Hello? You a freak?
I believe. I feel the scent of ash upon thee. Thou'rt the one of whom Uncle Gale spoke. The one to show me flame. Tis good. When this is done, may I return. The door is open thanks to thee. Tis good. I'll head off to paint.
Oh, you're the painter, huh?
Uncle Gale, I would. Tis good.
Okay.
When this is done.
Oh, and this will be a shortcut for somewhere later along the line. Excuse me. Another shortcut. Okay. Now here we get to see the Corvian village. Well, that was pretty simple. I'm guessing that they wanted to force you to come around here so that you could see all this. I mean, FromSoft, they put a lot of detail into their worlds. You know, I mean, you can see all the cobblestone in every brick, in every piece of that wall. So they put a lot of effort into making these, and they want you to see how beautiful their world is. So they brought you out to this nice balcony so that you could observe this particular environment. That's one of the best things about having a very high, very vertical map. You get to see everything. Okay. This guy looks different. I think. Ooh. Hello? Still haven't seen any of those horn-headed Viking-looking dudes that we see in the trailer. Just pure mountains. Big old bell over there. No! I forgot they could do that. Ah. Oh! Follower shield. Okay. I'll take a look at that in just a sec. Okay, no, not from that point. Shields. Follower shields. Physical 80. Let's see. Standard shield used by the Faerun followers. Crafted with wood and reinforced with metal. Imbued with a faint resistance to the abyss. And it uses your weapon skill. So it gives you a little bit of dark resistance as well. But you're more likely... Most people are probably just going to use the crest shield. Because that also... That gives you a lot of dark resistance. Unless Abyss is like a new element. Look at one of these bells. What is depicted here? Grapes? How about in the upper images? I can't quite make it out. Are those people? Flowers, maybe? I recently watched... Oh, it's the same depiction is down here. It almost looked like it almost looks like hand marks, like somebody put both of their hands down and made and then pressed them down on the metal. Interesting. I recently was watching the series Begin Japanology, and since FromSoft is a Japanese country or. FromSoft is a Japanese company, is what I meant to say. Oh, shit! Wasn't even look up. Oh, there's one of the big guys. Oh, boy. And since FromSoft is a Japanese company... Ow! He's working some crazy-ass magic around here. Oh, it's that dude! Okay. Soul of a great champion. Yeah, Grandis is definitely using that armor. Like, without a shadow of a doubt, Grandis will be using that armor. That is totally his style. Like, the whole set, probably. But Sakura is the one who wants that shield. Not to love about it. The idea behind the kite shield is that when you're using a round shield, standard shield, you have to actively block your legs. But with a kite shield, You can, you all just, all you have to do is hold it forward and it will automatically guard your legs. So you don't have to lower it, which reveals your upper body. It may not seem like much, but that's a big deal when it comes to sword fighting. Any exposure along your body means that your opponent has the ability or the potential to strike you down or severely injure you. What is this? Earthseeker. See, can Sakura use this? Okay, yes she can. Okay. Let's have a look. Yes, I know what this is, by the way, and I'll probably modify it and stuff when I get back, and then we'll continue, and then I'll use it in the next one. Wait, can that thing be buffed? No, it can't. Okay. I'll still use it. Just because. Yeah, I happened upon that. Complete accident. Total accident. I did not mean to go there. So what? Where am I going? I'm completely lost. Wait. Oh, so that must be the only direction we can go. Back there. I guess this little path, or that path back there, was specifically for dealing with a knight. Or a Viking. Or giant, or whatever the hell that thing really is. Oh, hi. Okay. I'm not going that way. It just so happens Earthseeker was one of the weapons that Sakura had her eye out for. As a matter of fact, it was the only weapon she had her eye out for. Complete happenstance. Okay, where, what, and why? What's going on here? Hold on. Okay, there's that, but that direction. I'm a bit lost. Did I already go up here? No, okay. Okay, now we're back on the right path. Be wary of jumping off. Yeah, I'll condone that. Yeah, I had never actually seen a platinum medal on a post before that one back at the champion area. Or maybe that was just a silver medal. Surroundings. FromSoft loves to ambush you. Ah! Oh, I actually have. We have seen these guys before, haven't we? I'll buy it. A little bit disappointing. Ooh. Seriously? that reminds me of Dark Souls 2. Of a particular area. Most of you will know. If you watched my previous walkthrough of Dark Souls 2, there was an area, I can't remember, it was like Hunter's Copse, where, oh, things just got creepy. Ew. Shoo, fly, don't bother me. So they're like the rats. They're just pathetic. Sorry, man. You picked on the wrong guy. I'm sorry. I couldn't help myself. They're flies. Literally. They're giant. Ugh. That's a word that I don't usually say. Ugh. If it's a word at all. Ah. Oh! You get raided. Well, they're not offensive. Ah. Ah. Like, there must be, like, some kind of hive mind, sensation or something going on. Hive mind sensation. That sounds like some kind of boy band. Okay, just on... I'm just gonna start killing these assholes just because I can't tell which ones are hostile and which ones aren't. Oh, I got worms! Shit! Should've been obvious. When you have a torch out, then you can't get worms, because the torch burns the worms off. Ah, Vilheim shit. This is just pathetic at this point. Sorry for him. Okay, sorry is not no longer sorry. That was nasty. A blood gem. I see. Okay, a shiver just went up my spine. Something's up. I do want to say one thing. These flies, they are a bit interesting in a way. Like, I could totally see an armor being made out of their, like, featuring their wing membranes. Like, something that mimics them. There's probably nothing here. But maybe there is. I mean, this place looks an awful lot like the catacombs from Bloodborne. Let's see what happens. Interesting. Secret door?
As secret door! Ashes will be ever seeking fire.
Secret door, secret door, secret door, secret door, secret door. Yeah, but this was literally a secret door, because it was behind a wall. The only reason I even found it was because of someone telling me. Yeah, see here, remember? You had to hit it. Oh, or you could have just fell down. Is that too? Oh god! Mwah! Bad stinky fly person. It was a poop. Really, there was a shiny poop over there? Freaking hell. Okay, let's see where we are. Ah, we were below this place. How circular.
Be forewarned, eager Ash. Even then would Ariandel remain our home.
Aye, sorry.
Leave us be, Ashen One. Sweep all thought of us from thy mind. As thy kind always have.
I'm sorry, but I'm curious.
Leave us be, Ashen One. Sweep all thought of us from thy mind, as thy kind always have.
You know, I paid for this DLC, so I'm going down here, no matter what you tell me to. Alright, lady, I paid for this. I've paid for the whole damn world. So please, shut the fuck up. Oh, hi.
Thanks for watching, sailors. You can help me burn cancer by clicking here. Join my crew if you're hungry for more, and I'll see you all in the next one. Sail on!